Hello everyone, welcome to Tong's Real World Data. This is Tong Wang. In this video, I will show you how to remove unneeded variables in R. The sample data is from my PhD dissertation, which was collected via Qualtrics surveys. The original data file contains 138 columns. However, many of them are not needed for my research questions. For example, some of the variables are generated by Qualtrics to track how much time my participants spend on each page. In this video, I will show you how to remove unneeded columns from your data in R. First, please set your working directory if you haven't already done so. If you are not sure how to do it, you can refer to my previous video, How to Import Your Data in R. And in my last video, I renamed all variables that I'm going to use for my research questions and saved the renamed data as an RDS file called mydata.renamed. So let's first load that data by using the read RDS function. And in R, I will give this data a name called mydata.renamed. I'm going to load the data using this function. Because I already set up my working directory, so I don't need to specify the file path. I only need to tell R the name of the data. And run it. Okay. Let's check the names of all columns by using the names function. MyData.renamed. In the console window, you can see in total there are 138 columns. And here you can see some variables are used to track participants' response behaviors, such as like first click, last click, page submit, and click count. In some research, these variables can be informative. However, these are irrelevant to my study. So today, I'm going to remove these unneeded columns or variables, and I will use the select function from the package of dpiyr. Let's load the package. dpiyr. Okay. And I'm going to give this subset data a new name called mydata.needed. This data will save all the columns that are useful for my research questions. And here I'm going to use a pipe operator in R. I'm going to introduce that briefly. Here, renamed. So remember that this is the data set I'm working on, which includes many unnecessary or useless variables. And here I use a pipe operator, which is percent greater than and percent. So you can simply think this as then. It pass my data set to the function I'm going to use. And as I said, I'm going to use the select function. Basically, it says I'm going to select a number of variables from this data set. And within the function, I'm going to add the variables that I would like to keep for my data analysis. Here I'm writing the code. Specifically, I intend to select ID, familiarity, all the variables containing FL, RGO, LPL, and interesting,
and all the variables between identification 1 and external 3, as well as several demographic information such as gender, age, and ethnicity.
Okay, now I have selected all the columns needed for my research. Let's run it. Okay, there is an error saying that it's not interpreted. Okay, here within the contains function, because I use multiple arguments, so here I need to combine them. Okay, now let's run it. Okay, it runs successfully. Check the names of the new data needed. Okay, now my new data contains 54 columns, and all these variables will be useful for my research. This is much clearer than the original data set. If you only have a few unneeded variables, you can do it in another way. You can remove the unneeded columns rather than selecting the needed ones. And we still use the select function. Let me show you how to remove unneeded variables. And I will give this data a different name. Still select from the renamed data. Use the pipeline. And see, as I said, we still use the select function. But here, we put in the variables unneeded for research questions. And to indicate that we don't want to keep these variables or these columns, we add a minus sign before them.
Here, I'm putting in the variables that I want to remove from my data. In my example, I do not want the variables from start date to user language. All the variables containing click or page, Q9, and the variables between Q50_16_text to Q54_6. Because in this example, I want to remove multiple columns, here I need to use a concatenate function.
Let's run it. Similarly, let's check the names of the columns. Data.needed1. Still, we have 54 useful columns in the new data set. So now we have successfully removed all unneeded columns from the sample data. We can say we have selected all needed columns for the research questions. I'm going to save the selected data as an R file called mydata.needed. As usual, you can find all the R codes in the lecture note. And in the next video, I will show you how to merge multiple data files in R. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.